Team 4 investigation tonight. Have you ever been pulled over for speeding?
No.
Yes, I have. It is not a pleasant experience.
Clearly not, and especially unpleasant for those drivers who are absolutely certain that they were not speeding. Team 4 took a closer look at the accuracy of those speed timing devices in police use in Pennsylvania. Is it possible that innocent drivers are getting ticketed here? Investigative reporter Jim Parsons here joins us with the answer.
You think it's possible?
I didn't say that.
It may be. It might be likely.
But you're going to see that maybe it is possible.
Okay.
And really, we got the idea, Wendy and Andrew, for this story from two different motorists who complained to us that they were wrongly ticketed for speeding. Now, police officers hear these kinds of complaints every day. So why are we giving them attention? Well, because maybe, just maybe, these guys have a point.
Earl Drack admits he likes to drive fast and has gotten his share of speeding tickets. And he says he's always paid them without a fight. But the last ticket Earl got...
I looked down at my speedometer when I was pulled over and didn't think I was going anywhere near the speed they said. And so that got me looking into this device that supposedly clocked me.
The device is called ENRADD, and funded by PennDOT, police departments throughout Pennsylvania are now using it.
Silver Chrysler 48.
ENRADD uses infrared beams to time the speed of a vehicle. It's a high-tech upgrade on the same principle as using a stopwatch to time a vehicle between two lines in the road. The old-fashioned stopwatch method is just how Dave Reismeyer got a speeding ticket last year.
If the officer is off by even as much as a quarter of a second, he's going to grossly overestimate your speed, which is what happened in my case.
Reismeyer beat his speeding ticket because the officer could not show proper certification for his stopwatch. And Reismeyer also argued that while police claimed he was going 64 miles per hour, the readout from his van's commercial GPS showed his speed at that moment was 57.
I think it's a tool to show that what they're currently using is not accurate.
He won't get an argument on that from police.
The speed timing, show the accuracy just isn't there with having to use a stopwatch manually and have vehicles run over the lines and try to time them.
But Monroeville's chief Doug Cole does believe in ENRADD's accuracy.
With ENRADD, you have to make sure that the beams are set up the correct
type. It's pretty simple once you get there, though. I mean, once you get involved, there's a tone that tells you that it's set up correctly.
Get your alignment, see if it's lined up.
Yeah, that one is.
Once officers trained in the proper setup of ENRADD hear that tone, they know the two units are communicating with each other across the street. But Earl Drack says there's still a potential for error.
An inch difference right here could easily translate to an inch difference out on the road.
Drack is a Cornell-educated engineer who has sketched out a theory about how ENRADD could get it wrong if the beams, positioned 3 feet apart, are not set up at exactly the same height.
Where the error can creep in is if the distance traveled by the car between the beam brake to start the timer and the beam brake to stop the timer is different than 3 feet. And that would be the case if the first timer were started by, say, the tires at the front of the car, and the second beam, because it is a different height, is stopped by, say, the bumper.
And when the beams are set up at different heights, the unit still gives police officers that tone. Team 4 took Earl Drack's theory to Professor Marlon Mickle at the University of Pittsburgh School of Engineering.
Once you set up the ENRADD, if you set it up properly, then you should be able to get consistent results. It's the proper setup, and to make sure that the point that you're catching is really, you want to catch the same point.
What happens if you don't?
You get some inaccuracies.
Professor Mickle has testified as an expert witness for Pennsylvania State Police on the use of radar. So no better person to ask, which is more accurate, ENRADD or radar?
Radar would be more accurate than ENRADD.
So why don't local police just use radar? Because in Pennsylvania, it's against the law. In fact, we're the only state in the nation that bans municipal police officers from using radar. And state lawmakers have failed to enact legislation that would change that.
I'm completely supportive of any tool that is being deployed for the purpose of advancing public safety. But the resistance that existed in Pennsylvania to radar has been the concerns that come from the speed trap towns. And they're still out there.
But the Police Chiefs Association says the speed trap town excuse is just that, an excuse.
Some of the legislation that was put forth had answers to that you couldn't make money with. In other words, the fine didn't go back to the municipality.
This chief and these two motorists charged with speeding all agree that radar's time has come.
I think the solution is that the local police should be able to use radar.
Now, there are two bills in the state Senate right now that would legalize radar for local police in Pennsylvania, but both have been stuck in committee for a year. We also spoke with the president of the company that manufactures ENRADD, and he says the device is just as accurate as radar if used properly. Jim Cowden of YIS Cowden Group says, could somebody set this up wrong and screw the public with an erroneous reading? Yes, but they could do the same thing with radar. And at some point, he says, the integrity of the police officer who's trained in the proper use of ENRADD has to come into play.
Sure.
And all the officers that we know of in Western Pennsylvania who are using ENRADD have been certified and properly trained on it.
You almost had me, very confused at the diagram and all that engineering, but once you described how it all works and how the bumper or the tire can make a different reading.
Especially when you're only talking 3 feet, a difference of a couple of inches or even an inch could
be a ticket.
Could be a ticket.
Great story.
Yes, Jim. Thank you. Well,